first ever marathon.
One of the baffle plate ruptures.
The
Delta race.
He went in, bringing on all the kids that were still alive. Gentlemen, be prepared.
Is there any way at all on that?
to report, Miss Piper.
Oh, yes, sir. I'm afraid our investigation turned up very little, Commodore. There is, of course, Mr. Spock's year of service to Captain Pike. Indications of his extreme loyalty to his fellow commander.
Miss Piper, a Vulcan can no sooner be disloyal than he can exist without reason. That goes for his present manner as well as his past.
We're forced to consider every possibility, sir. We can be certain Captain Pike could not have sent that message. In his condition, he's under observation every minute of every day.
And totally unable to move. His wheelchair is constructed to respond to his brainwaves. Oh, he can turn it, move it forwards. But that's it, too. That's as much as that poor devil can do. Oh, his mind is as active as yours. He's fine, but he's trapped. A useless vegetating body. He's kept alive mechanically with a battery-driven heart.
Then there's no way he could have even asked for that message to be sent.
Starbase operations.
Starbase operations.
Starbase operations.
Starbase operations. Starbase operations. Stand by. Stand by to receive new orders, Enterprise.
Starbase operations, Mr. Scott.
Starbase operations, Enterprise. Stand by to receive new orders. They are to be fed directly to the ship's computers. This is top secret and scrambled.
Enterprise standing by. Uhura, request confirmation.
Enterprise is Starbase. Request confirmation.
Sir, this is the security area. What are you doing here?
I have security clearance.
Repeat, Enterprise to Starbase. We need operating confirmation for the ship's captain. Come in, Starbase. Come in, Captain Kirk!
This is Captain Kirk. You have confirmation, Mrs. Murray.
Scotty, Captain! Our destination has been scrambled in into the ship's computers. How can I handle the helm if I don't know where we're going?
Mr. Sparks would be here. He'll answer all questions.
This is Mr. Spock. Ships computers will handle the helm on this voyage, Mr. Scott. Orders will be computed and set off manually. You will not discuss this with the ship's crew or Starbase personnel. Do you read?
Acknowledge, sir.
Stand by. We'll warp other orbit in 1 hour.
Have you?
And that happens completely subverse. To be caught acting like a freeman,
interfering with my command and my ship. I don't know who it is, but I mean to find out. Even you! I thought you had the technical know-how. I suspect you, but you don't. There's a false entry in the log right now. It's a judge speak with the established facts. I'm going to explain that.
I can't. But the question's fucked of all people. Me, yes. I can go off half time, given the good reason. How can you? Not so much. It's impossible.
Mr. McCoy, the transporter control.
Oh, here.
You're needed aboard the Enterprise, Doctor. Medical emergency.
Well, what is it? Sickness? Injury? How bad is it?
That's all we have on it, Doctor. Just needed aboard.
Probably someone discovered a hangman.
Follows Spock's instructions to the letter. scanners before Goddamn following us about the size of a Starbase shuttlecraft. Shall we reverse engines?
We'll take no action, Mr. Hanson.
Scott here, sir. At our speed, she'll never catch us. But if they want to reach us...
Mr. Scott, we have our orders. We'll maintain radio silence. Starbase shuttlecraft 1 to the Enterprise. Come in, please. Enterprise! This is Commodore Mendez and Captain Kirk. If you read me, you are ordered to reply. Repeating on all emergency frequencies, Jim. Spalky is headed for Telos 4, all right.
Pulling ahead of us fast. Fuel's down to 63.3. If we turn back now, we've got just barely enough to get back to base.
Shuttlecraft Enterprise, come in. Shuttlecraft to Enterprise, come in.
Enterprise, come in.
Library computer.
Computer. Mention the object now following Enterprise.
Computed. Object is Class F shuttlecraft. Duranium metal shell. Ion engine power.
Stop. How long before shuttle's fuel supply forces return to Starbase?
Computed. Shuttlecraft is already past point of safe return.
No practical benefits to mankind on Talos 4.
Spock would have some kind of logical reason for going there.
Maybe. But maybe he's just gone mad.
I keep wondering who could be following us at that shuttlecraft. And I keep coming up with the same excuse. But I can't be right, can I, Mr. Spock?
Computer, lock on to the object now following the Enterprise.
Locked on. Tractor beam ready.
Go to tape Able 7th Baker. Execute instructions.
Isn't the captain, Mr. Spock?
This is for Officer Spock. Security, send an armed team to the bridge. Transporter room, prepare to beam Captain Kirk aboard. Effective until that time, Lieutenant Commander Scott will be in operational control.
So,
Doctor, as senior officer president, I present myself to you for arrest.
What?
The charge, Doctor, is mutiny. I never received orders to take that.
Security reporting.
Doctor?
Mr. Spock is under arrest. His climate report is enough.
Not even. I'll make no call.
What can find him?
What is it?
Captain from Bridge. The engines are coming on.
Reverse power! Hold this position. Tell them I'm giving those orders wherever they are.
There's no one up here giving orders. Mr. Spock, he has the computers running this ship.
Uhura! Disengage or get a control.
We can't disengage, Captain. The helm does not respond.
Computer control, come in.
Computer.
Disengage helm.
Unable to comply. Any such attempt will cross-circuit vessel's life supporting system. Computer control cannot be disengaged until vessel reaches planet Talon 4.
Your evidence. Screen on.
Mr. Spock, that's impossible. No ship makes records in that detail, that. What were we wanting?
I cannot tell you at this time, Captain.
Captain Pike.
Were any record tapes of this nature made during your voyage? This court is not obliged to view evidence without knowing its source.
Unless the court asks the prisoner why.
You did ask that question.
You mean I was maneuvered into asking? Your evidence is out of order.
I'm forced to contest that, Commodore. I want to see more.
You have that right, Captain.
But just because the prisoner is your first officer and your close personal friend,
that has nothing to do with it.
Very well. Continue.
Spring on, Mr. Stark.
Except yourself. And
bet I'm tired. You bet. I'm tired of being responsible for 203 lives. I'm tired of deciding which mission is too risky and which isn't. Who goes on a landing party and who doesn't? Who lives and
who dies?
Now I've had it, Bill.
To the point of finally taking my advice, arrest leave.
To the point of considering resigning.
Then do what?
Well, for one thing, go home. A nice little town with 50 miles of parkland around. Remember I told you I had two horses? Used to take some food and ride out all day.
That sounds exciting. Ride out with a picnic lunch every day.
So that's one place I might go. All right. I'm going to business on Regulus or on the Orion Colony.
You, an Orion trader dealing in green animal women slaves?
The point is, this is not the only life available. There's a whole galaxy of things to choose from.
Not for you. A man either lives like this, eats it head on and licks it, or he turns his back on it and he starts to wither away.
Now you're starting to sound like a doctor, bartender.
You take your choice. We both get the same two types of customers, the living and the dying.
Spock here. We've intercepted a follow-up message, sir. There are craft survivors on Talos.
Thank you.
Morgan's Law, supplemental. Mrs. Spock, on trial for mutiny, has forced the court to accept unusual evidence. On our monitor screen, the voyage of Captain Pike and the Enterprise to the one forbidden world in all the galaxy.
Screen on.
If they can spare you a moment, I'd like to make my medical report.
I think it's time to show.
Green Card, come in.
There is no survivors from Captain Number One. This is all some sort of a trap. We lost the captain.
What is it?
Message for Commodore Mendez. Commodore Mendez, urgent. Subspace monitor show. Enterprise receiving transmissions from planet Talos 4 in violation of Starfleet General Orders.
Receiving transmissions from Talos 4. Then the images we've been seeing
are coming from Talos 4.
Captain Kirk is hereby relieved. You are ordered to assume command of the Enterprise. Disable vessel if necessary. Prevent further contact. Message signed, Council, Starfleet Command.
Mr. Spock, you are aware of the orders regarding any contact with Talos IV. You have deliberately invited the death penalty. And you've not only finished yourself, Spock, you've finished your captain as well.
Commodore must be aware that Captain Kirk knew nothing of this.
And you are aware that a captain is responsible for everything that occurs on his vessel. I order you to return this ship back to manual control.
Sir, I must respectfully decline.
Very well, Spock.
Beings who could make a man believe he was seeing anything they wished he was seeing, and
Captain Pike was gone. A prisoner for some unknown purpose.
Then the images we've been seeing
are coming from Talos 4, sir.
Mr. Spock, you are aware of the orders regarding any contact with Talos 4. You have deliberately invited the death penalty.
You know what you're doing. Have you lost your mind?
Captain. Jim. Please. Don't stop me. Don't let him stop you. It's your career and Captain Pike's life. You must see the rest of the transmission.
Session. Despite all we can do, images still continue to be transmitted to us from Talos 4.
Nothing has ordered your contact with Talos 4. They made no exception.
I'm sorry, sir. The keeper controls our screen now. We cannot change that. As you saw before, gentlemen, 13 years ago, Talosian said not Captain Christopher Pike unconscious and taken him as prisoner.
Begin the experiment.
inhabitants of those considerably more vegetation or some plants simply took bearings of one mind.
So, we just thought we saw survivors down there.
Exactly. An illusion placed in our minds by this planet's inhabitants.
It was a perfect illusion. They had us seeing just what we wanted to see. Human beings that survived with dignity and bravery. Everything entirely logical, right down to the building of the camp and tattered clothes, everything. Now let's be sure we understand the danger of all this. The inhabitants of this planet can read our minds. They can create illusions out of a person's own thoughts and memories and experiences, even out of a person's own desires. They can create an illusion just as real and solid as this chair. And it's impossible to ignore.
It's Captain Clancy, God, he needs help. If we start buzzing about down there, the liable to find their mental power is so great to reach out and swat this ship as if it were a fly.
Now, these engines are the hands they... We can transfer ship's power against it. Enough to blast half a continent.
The engineering deck will transmit to great ship's power. We'll try blasting through that metal.
Thank you.
they know that Captain Pike is fatigued. We can reconvene later.
Then they care about the captain.
They want him back soon.
Alive? I demand to know why.
If you'll be patient, Commodore, the answer to your question...
You're forgetting you're on trial, Spock. You will answer all questions put to you.
My answers to your questions would be most unbelievable, sir. I'm afraid you'll have to wait and see it there.
Thank you.
they control my mind.
Oh, I tell you, then we've kept some dream you had and let me live it with you?
Perhaps.
They can't let you make you do anything you don't want to.
But they try to trick me with their illusions.
And they can punish you when you're not cooperative. You'll find out about that.
Do they ever live on the surface of this planet? Why did they go underground?
War. Thousands of centuries ago.
So that's why it's so barren up there.
Now becoming able to support life again.
So, the Talosians who came underground found life limited here and concentrated on developing their mental power.
They found it's a trap, like narcotics, because when dreams become more important than reality, you give up travel, building, creating, and even forget how to repair the machines left behind by your ancestors. They're living and reliving other lives left behind in the thought record.
Or probing the minds of Zeus specimens like me.
Better than the theater, too. They create an illusion for you, watch you react, feel your emotions. They have a hope that you descendants of life brought back long ago from all over this part of the galaxy.
Which means they had to have more than one of each animal.
Please.
They'll need a pair of humans, too. What are they intending of the Earth be men?
You said that if I answered your question.
But that was a bargain with something that didn't exist. You said you weren't real, remember?
I am a woman. As real and as human as you are. You're like Adam and Eve. If we could...
Assuming that's a lie, why would you want me attracted to her? So I'll feel love in a husband-wife relationship. That'd be necessary only if you intended to build a family group or a whole human community.
With the female now properly conditioned.
You mean properly punished? I'm the one who's not cooperating. Why don't you punish me?
First, an emotion of protectiveness. Now one of sympathy.
Thank you.
from sunny Orlando, Florida. Where's Chapel? Can you describe your relationship with the captain of Spock?
Great, Zach. I love him so, but I need more emotion.
Mr. Spock, you get a reply, sir. I should think that great sex would be enough. The emotion is a foolish, lot waste of time.
Evidence from the past. How the Talosians, planning to breed a society of human slaves, tempted Captain Pike with the Earth woman they held in captivity. And as she appeared,
he's already picked me.
resist the present specimen, you now have a selection.
I'll break out of this cage somehow and get to you. Is your blood red like ours? I'm going to find out.
Each of the two new arrivals has qualities in her favor. The female you call number one has a superior mind and will produce highly intelligent offspring.
All I want to do is get my hands on you. Can you read these thoughts? Images of hate, killing.
The other new arrival has considered you unreachable, but has now realized that this has changed. The qualities in her favor are youth, strength, plus unusually strong female drives.
You'll find my thoughts more interesting. Thoughts so primitive you can't understand. Thoughts so
wrong-thinking is punishable. Right-thinking will be as quickly rewarded. You will find an effective combination.
Captain.
No! No! No, don't help me. I have to concentrate. They can't breathe through hate.
Guilty. As charged. is your brain.
Oh.
This is mine.
The Keeper controls our vessel now, as he did 13 years ago. Gentlemen, you have asked me why. You will see now.
Found me in the wreckage.
dying. A lump of flesh. They rebuild me. Everything works, but they have never seen a human before. They had no guide for putting me back together.
This was necessary in order to convince you her desire to stay was an honest one.
Don't give her back for illusion of beauty.
And more.
Captain Pike, I'm losing. Service Department sent for transport commander.
Rumor has it that
Commander Shelby has played a hand or two.
Thank you. Thank you. still doing good, Deanna. I pushed myself hard to get this far. I sacrificed a lot. I always said I wanted my own command, and yet something's holding me back. Is it wrong for me to want to stay?
What do you think?
Maybe I'm just afraid of being scared.
I don't think so.
The captain says that Shelby reminds me of the way that I used to be. He's right. She comes in here full of drive and ambition, impatient, taking risks. I look at her and I wonder what happened to those things in me. I like those things about me. Plus.
You mean you're older, more experienced, a little more seasoned. I don't think you've lost a thing. And I think you've gained more than you realize. You're much more comfortable with yourself than you used to be.
That's just it. I'm too comfortable here.
I'm not sure I know what that means. You're happy here. Happier than I've ever known you to be. So it comes down to a simple question. What do you want, Phil Riker?
Thank you.
the robot. Move to intercept.
Aye, sir.
Captain, enough authority and support to intercept. Reporting warp 9.3. Entering visual range.
On screen!
Engage!
said drop the power for this system. It is system one. It's written frequency spread within a high tail band. It is reasonable to conclude that the ship's power distribution is vulnerable to those frequencies. We can generate a concentrated order of power at the same distribution frequency. I mean, a lot more than our phase of both our computers would provide.
Well, how do we do that?
You mean deflector dish?
Half-past hour of feeding on Klingon TV. 4.2. The Enterprise remains concealed in the dust cloud, and to my surprise, the Borg have maintained their position, waiting for us to come out of hiding. I have no explanation or special interest in me or the ship. We continue to prepare our defenses for the inevitable confrontation. But I must admit, on this night, I contemplate the distinct possibility that no defense may be adequate against this enemy.
Captain!
I'm sorry I didn't get to know you better, but you take care.
Thank you.
9.4. 9.6.
Stay with him! Riker O'Brien can give me a fix of the captain!
You want a signal?
Senior officers, report to the bridge.
Sir, the coordinates they have set, they are on a direct course for sector 00.
Energized.
recorder functions minimal.
Any signs of human life?
Inconclusive.
Look at this! This is extraordinary!
He's appearing as some kind of power waveguide conduit without the force to function electrically if it were not
the matter. There's no way we can take out enough leads to disable him. What if we look at this from a
mosquito perspective? Interesting metaphor. What is your idea?
Stick
them in
your
tank of
scotch. They might stop for a minute to scratch.
Distribution.
You have to communicate. It is still activated.
Pressure to the car. Can you hear me? Can you locate it for?
This way.
I strongly recommend redeploying all available defenses to protect Sector 001, Admiral.
Power
down
in
this game.
Picard!
Nothing yet, sir.
Answer that.
From this time forward, you will service us.
our culture will adapt to service hours. It has been decided that a human voice will speak for us in all communications.
Men, we're being hailed. Let's move.
Us free.
The knowledge and experience of the human decor is part of us now. It has prepared us for all possible courses of action. Your existence is hopeless, number one.
And now, the exciting conclusion.
I got to know him very, very well. Luke Picard. And there is no way in hell that he would assist the Borg. I want that clear.
Yes, Admiral.
He is a casualty of war.
And we've abandoned all hope of recovery.
In less than 24 hours, this armada's going to hit that Borg vessel with everything we can muster. Either they survive or we do. Mr. Picard, a great man has been lost. Your captain, my friend. Commander Riker, I hereby promote you to the field commission of captain. The Enterprise is your ship now. Congratulations. I wish the circumstances were different.
Likewise. Good luck, Admiral.
To us all!